You know, I've only been an intern for a week, but I feel like I'm really starting to figure out how things work around here.
Well, ma'am, I'm sure that abdominal swelling will go down in a couple of weeks. Come back if you have any problems, okay?
Doctor, we're checking this patient in. She's going into labor.
I thought maybe she'd like some air before her baby comes?
Well, even though there are some things I'm still figuring out, I still feel pretty confident. But there is something that I've been dreading since I've come here. Oh, it's my first night on call. I can't do this all on my own. No, I know I'm no Superman. Superman. Your first night on call is the night every intern dreads the most. The lives of the entire hospital are in your hands. I remember the first time I was on call as a med student.
Oh, back so soon. I see you have my laundry. No, don't give it to me here. Take it to my car. Oh, and while you're out there, get me some donuts and some coffee from across the street. Oh, young and restless.
Dang it, always too much starch in those colors. You know, it's gonna be a scary night, but I know my mentor will have some great words of advice.
Listen up, newbie. You're gonna kill somebody. Some point during your residency, you're gonna screw up and they're gonna die. What I'm saying here, newbie, is the harder you study, the longer you're gonna stave off that first kill from happening to you. All I can hope for in the end is that poor soul that you kill is some jackass with no family.
Oh, thanks for the encouragement. I think I need to go to the bathroom.
No problem, Ginger. I'll see you in the morning.
After vomiting in the bathroom for an hour, I figured that maybe things won't be as bad as he says. At least I won't be alone. The senior resident is on with me tonight, and I'm sure he'll back me up whenever I need him.
How's it going? I don't usually cover this unit, but I'm on tonight. I'll be sleeping in here. So, don't come and get me unless you kill somebody or something. Okay, alright, yeah, good night.
Then again, maybe I'm screwed. Being on call is like a fight to survive. You never know what the hospital is going to throw at you, so you always need to keep your guard up.
And thumping in time, the green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver, and muscle for rank.
Get off my neck, crazy drunk!
Relentless and wild, they move through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up as they get out of town. The arena's empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left me.
I've got a bad itch. Yeah.
My pain meds?
Oh, yeah, right. I'll get your nurse to bring him in.
Okay.
Yeah.
And also, I'm getting a little hungry.
Okay.
Come on. No fear. No fear. It's always good to recycle.
I just need you to sign this order for the patient in 2B.
You know, I thought being on call would be a lot worse, but actually it's really not that bad. I think I can handle anything the hospital throws at me. There you go.
Thank you. How are you then?
As soon as I said those words, I knew the hospital was waiting to unleash its fury.
Someone's coding.
When someone codes, it means the patient has either stopped breathing or his heart has stopped beating. The doctor's job at this point is to look death in the eye and give them another chance at life. The doctor can have no fear as he faces death head on. I knew what I needed to do.
Someone's coding and they're gonna die!
You woke me up from a good dream, is that all? Go do what the nurses tell you to, they've done it 1,000 times. And don't come back here until 7 a.m. We'll get going! You're gonna die!
As I looked at that room, I knew my greatest fear was waiting in there for me.
No! You're not my father! No!
Doctor, what are you doing? We need your help at the code.
Sometimes, you just have to face your fears head on. As I walked out of that room, I knew I had conquered my fears, and in the process, I had saved someone's life.
Good job with that Foley.
It's what my hands were meant to do!
Now that I've looked death in the eye and threw it to the side, there's nothing in the hospital that can knock me down. Hi there. I'm a doctor.
Don't!
Hospital, I hate you.
Intern! No sleeping on the job! Here until 7. 7 in the morning.
Your face is falling off.
Hello.
Out the door, just in time. It's time for 4:05. Gotta meet the new boss by 8 a.m.
1, 2, 3.
Rings in the car. Wow. My wife is working hard. She's running late tonight again.
Okay. You went into labor.
Well, you know what I've been told. You gotta work to feed the soul. I'm no Superman.
No sleeping on the job!
Oh,
baby! Ah, I hate you!
You've got your love time. You think you're doing fine, but you're just plugged into the wall. And that deck of tarot cards won't get you very far. There ain't no hand to break your fall. Well, I know what I've been told. You gotta know just when to fold. But I can't do this all on my own. No, I know I'm no Superman.